16. Okay.
So we should be back now. It's going to take a little while for my game to load in properly. Let's just say I need to get my PC to a computer shop tomorrow. No, PC crashed. RAM fault again. Hey SG, so I put 4 new RAM sticks in today to replace the 4 the faulty ones, and that's just crashed again. So if it goes again tonight, that will be it. I think I may have a faulty RAM slot on my motherboard. I'll need to sort out. You can do, Nathan. Yeah, give it a chance to settle down, SG. It's not been up very long. So if the PC crash again, I won't be back. Just have to hope they can look at it fairly quickly. Just wondering why it's doing it. Let me know if the stream settles down. So everything seems to be okay this end. Not get any drop frames or anything this end, so it's YouTube department. So I know that square on the headlands has been cut, so I don't know why it's still there. It just hasn't loaded in properly for me. Everything seems to be an issue at the moment, Stephen. Not going to cut that square again because I know it's not there. It's there to me, but no one else. So I doubt you can see that square of grass, can you, Milton? On the headland?
No, I can't.
No. So it just hasn't loaded in properly my end this time. Alright, we'll only get this field cut. Get this one cleared up, all being well. No PC crash, Terrier. RAM faults again. We are going to be using Richard Weston trailers, Stephen, all being well. What's the stream looking like now? Just out of interest. There's one Richard Weston silage trailer in the yard. Okay then. Yep, there's one Richard Weston in the clamp round there. Let's buy another one. Get the forage harvester. And get out of this yard. So I'm getting a few lag issues here. No, it's not, Jeremy. I'm now getting it as well. I think we're going to.
I'm having it.
It's the server, then, isn't it, again? I think we're going to have a sale on here.
We need to clear some bales.
We do. New hospital, Stephen. Yeah, we've got to get some of these bales out of this yard. Certainly have, Stephen. Well, we're going to sell some anyway, Nathan, so I know we'll do that. Hi, Sam, how are you doing? The hospital will be my PC tomorrow. So we're about to find out if this works properly. It's had a food test done to it, but we'll find out very, very shortly, Nathan. Hi, Senna, how are we doing? You won't have done, Stephen. It didn't exist before 4 o'clock this morning.
How many salvage trails do we owe?
Should be 2 western ones.
Okay.
One at the shop still.
Ah.
It hasn't been delivered to the yard yet. Don't know what to suggest with that one, Sam. Are you ready, Nathan? I think we probably could go around the other way, aren't we, Jeremy? So you can... It seems to be, Nathan. We see grass textures going in the header, we see grass going in the trailer. The trailer driver's not reporting anything's not showing. They would test it first, Sam, before they paid you for it. Literally get this field done tonight, all being well. Nathan converted it for us, Stephen. Certainly working better than the other one. Evening, Chris, how are we doing? Yeah, let's just say Nathan was getting a teeny bit stressed with it about 4 hours ago. Wasn't quite behaving itself. Not even been tested on the server yet. Not tried on a tractor, so I may even have to go and get one of the 70 series to put on it. Thought you might have been Chris for some reason. I just need to do something. I think we might need the 70 series. We'll see. It's just that little corner that was making a struggle. Yeah, this is just a little something we had a chat about after the stream last night. When we tried the New Holland out again, we're struggling with it. As you can imagine, this forager is private. I know 4D, I think, is working on this one. I don't know much about CEX, I've not had any dealings with them. I know Dal knows a bit about them. GD dealt with them. That's not bad, Chris. I need to take my PC into Dearham Computers tomorrow. I think one of the RAM slots has failed on the motherboard. That's a minor little one, that is. Oh, it's crashed already once tonight, Chris, before you arrived. So if I disappear again, it's the PC that's crashed. It is Nathan. Working well. 1650 won't be too bad. It might do, Tractor Guy. Certainly one to put in your diaries. There won't be one next Wednesday night because I'm down in Essex for 2 days. Shop is usually fairly good. It seems when I'm using RAM slots 3 and 4, I don't like it too much. It might just be something I've not done properly. So I'll get them to have a look at it. I get positioned for a screenshot, don't always work well. This has got a nice wide pickup range on it. We've now got a proper late 90s foraging setup here. Mengele chopper and Western trailers. Yeah, this is the 17 mod which has been skillfully converted, it just needs a finishing properly. Nathan's calmed down a bit from when he was doing it originally. There's no major errors with it, all works, that's the main thing. Oh yes, we tested the forge on the one of these trailers last night, and there's a bit of a interesting one, shall we say. PC crashed, Mike, with a RAM fault again. Does, because it's not very old and it's new RAM, so I have to have a word with the shop tomorrow about that. I should have known when TeamSpeak didn't open properly to start with tonight. It is a new motherboard, Chris, the whole thing is new. PC was put together in May. Yeah, I'll have to speak to them about that. So the thought of the motherboard has failed, that's a warranty job. Don't think so, Mike. Now, you wouldn't have thought so. I just love it when servers don't load back in properly. Brand new RAM delivered yesterday, Chris, only put it in today. I've now got two RAM sticks in slots 1 and 2 and not using 3 and 4. So we'll see what happens. I do, Mike. There should be a link going around. Hold on. Should be a link going to chat any second for it. Too slow, Terrier. I'm liking this forager. That's weird. Where have the grass textures gone? Hang on, I've got an idea. Nope. Little error for you there, Nathan. There were grass textures in that when we first started. When we had that green grass. Really green grass going through it. No, there aren't. It's weird. Yeah, that's not a bad map, Chris. I did have a day or two early to look at. Yes, I would say it's something to do with this grass texture. Because where it has the dark green stuff, it is okay. If that's the only area we've got with it, you've done a damn good job with it. We have done a damn good job with it. No two ways about that. Probably think of better things being up 4 o'clock in the morning to do. Hey, Pray for Cap, welcome along. That tractor really needs repainting. Don't mind a little bit of wear, but that looks horrible.
He only has 23 hours.
How many?
23.
I have no idea on that one, Sam. Best thing to do is see what he's up to is check his Facebook page. Everything's on there. I think we're to the point we could really do with a third trailer at this rate.
Yeah, we need one more.
Yeah. It is, Stephen. That's what we said last.
We have one more driver on field 28.
Yeah, but we've got to talk him into actually getting on the stream, haven't we? Oh, Nathan's on his way. Okay, Mike. Yeah, we were talking off the stream last night. Steve was saying this is a damn good forage harvester, but the Lely version would be too new. Whereas if it was done in the old Rico and Mengele colours, it'd be perfect. And let's face it, it's pretty perfect for what we're looking for. Now we certainly know what the grass will yield when it's fully fertilised on here. Next question will be, will the clamp take all of it? These particular ones are Pray for Cap, but there are some out there that are not. There are some listed on Behind the Hedges Facebook page, which are not private. He might just put them to the wayside for now, Sam, because he did have a break from modding for a while. We ain't just had a collision on the road, have we?
On the bale stack.
You've not hit the bale stack, have you?
Yeah. Just you.
Behind the Hedge Photography, I think it's called. Still look this corner of the field, that is for certain. Didn't know if everyone could see them, tractor guy. Not sure where Nathan put them in there. Back in about February, I think it was, because they were the first ones I put on here. There are one or two errors with them. Ah, there we go then. Got the boss checking on his toy now. Yeah, JF-1050. I'm quite happy to have a Mengele four-wheel half-strong, eh? Let's face it, if you want the high-output trailed harvester, this is one of the ones you picked. These are tarps, which there's still one locally that I know of. What's the boss's opinion of his masterpiece then, as he's driving beside? Spoiler, good setup, Sam. Ah, working well, isn't it, Nathan? Working better than the New Holland does. Yeah, that is a bit of a shame on that one, Stephen. We just gained part swath down this end. I'm sure there's only two between us a little while ago. These ones are fine, Sam. There ain't actually much horsepower difference between the tractors. I think the 7800s are 180 and these ones are 1560. I think it'll make too much difference. So we've got the tuned 8340s. The old Jag 75. Almost perfect there. Okay, catch you later, Terrier. Enjoy your takeaway. I'll be staying on the chopper, Sam. Don't see many double chops around now. Don't like this hill down the bottom there. I'll just clear these few little bits up to tidy up. I have no idea, Stephen. I think it depends on Tom's real world commitments, what I've been told. Quickly checking something. Aiden and Lee, thanks for that one. Am I right in thinking that VF is not going live today? I see no signs. Can't remember what he said. Got nearly as many trailer falls off this field as we had off that bigger one last time. Blimey, we are doing well then. Anyone know what BF's doing? Because I haven't seen anything. So I'll just try and check. Seen nothing scheduled.
Yeah, nothing in my institute.
No, they wouldn't elite. Those texture mods are specific to what you see. If they're on the map, you would. Right, if anyone does see anything, let me know. I'll keep going in the meantime. I have a feeling he's elsewhere, from memory. That's what I thought, Thomas. Welcome along. I couldn't remember what he'd said at the weekend, because I'm getting old and forgetful. These tractors would do for certain on a British Irish farm. There's a 6-furrow Vogel and Newt plough out there. We should look the part. The 8970s, the Dominators, the New Holland TX combines. Yeah, that's what I think, Thomas. I know he's on holiday this week as well from work, same as I am. Feeling that Gamescom featured in it somewhere as well. Couldn't remember. One thing is certain, this grass looks better than the other. Eight likes? Sure, we can do better than that, can't we? If you just joined us, that patch of grass has nothing to do with being missed. If the server hasn't spawned in for me. Yeah, it's just finding what you want to use, isn't it, Elite? That's the main thing. Is that trailer full? I've got nothing coming out of Forager. I think that's an oops moment.
Yeah, distract us.
He's hitting your new forage harvester, Nathan. Ugh, lag. We certainly have had lag on here tonight. I think we need to ship some of these bales out. I don't think they're just affecting the yard anymore, how many we've got. Check the prices in the yard sell point. I think the server's been twitchy all day from what Jeremy said earlier. It's a school holiday, so there's probably more people playing on than normal in a work day. Right. Is that field done? I'll just mince that little bit up. Let's just save that. I think it's the fact that Matt wanted to do something what hadn't been done. That's not bad off this little field, Nathan. Well done, 1174. I think that makes him just in time to grab a mower, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend that, because if too many people mess around with his mod, he's going to just say, sod it and not do any more. Yeah, look at how many fields we put in that other pit. The lag is real when we get near the yard. Oh boy, is that bad. It's all these bales. Who hit the hay bales?
Me.
Oops. I'll just drop the forager there out of the way. It does sort itself out once the stand goes down and up. Now, he threatens it occasionally. Who put the loader in front of the mowers? Nathan. Right, what is the price in the yard here for silage? $106. No, we can't afford to sell any hay, Sam. Silage we can afford to get rid of, hay we cannot. Tell me you've got a tractor with a load of brackets on it. Back to plan A. Just take the loader off this one and move it. Alright, I'll leave you guys to get some mowing sorted. I'm gonna get rid of some of these silage bales.
Okay, which field?
The big one on the left of the road as you go down. I think it's the one we said, wasn't it? We have one or two on, eh? Okay, Jeremy. If we don't get rid of some of these bales, we've got a big problem.
Field 7?
Yes, field 7.
Okay.
That with the white on the back. We've got sheep as well, Sam. That's what we need so much. I wonder how many bales I can pick up at once with this. How did last night go, Chris? Did she last, or was it by midnight? I meant to ask. What's that zone marker there? That used to be the still the sell point there. What's that? Our milk, I suppose. Blimey. Yeah, well, I'll let you get that mower out first before I go in there. Okay, that was 74. If I can get these in the sell point with the mowers there. It's a bit light on the back. CNC. Don't think so. So just get some mowers out of that sell point. It's another private one, Sam. It's a Nathan special. Oh, if that's the one I think it was, I wasn't too impressed with it in 17. Needed work in 17 when that came out. I was going to do a review of it, but took one look at it and thought I can't. Yeah, I'm thinking that could be a possibility, Jeremy, that one. Yep, it is certainly light on the back. Interesting. Wasn't that far without doing that trick. $425 a bale. I'd worked out between $400 and $500 a bale when we done them, so that's not bad. Maybe the first time I had a tractor loader like that. I don't mean in game. These bales are a bit heavier than the last ones we've done. I have no idea.
Field 7, Jeremy.
Have an idea. May not be a good one, but still an idea. This isn't the loader for this tractor. It's the loader for one of the bigger ones. I've got the baby tractor with a big loader at the minute. This one, the ones off of the 8340s and 7840s. Not one of the little four-cylinder babies I've got here. So as worst case, we'd always get a silo to store the silage in. The first time we'd done that, was it, Milton?
No, we used to store the hay.
Yeah. Rather than buy another pit, maybe we just get a silo what can store it. Empty the pit into it. Shame that gate opens that way. That's not going to make it easy, is it? Yeah, got both stacks to do, so it don't really matter. All these bales in the yard are for sale other than the high ones. I'm just waiting for the price to go up at this point to be able to do it. And get them ones in a second. Won't do this for the rest of the stream, don't worry. Now HVV, you said the same thing in here last night. It makes me think you're just here to try and cause trouble. You know, that sort of thing. Shall we be brave? Do you consider that brave or daft? As long as they don't leave the ground, we're fine. It's going to be quite a bit of money from all these once we've sold them. Optimistic, highly questionable if you've done it in reality. Let's face it, how heavy silage bales are in real life, that'd be very optimistic. Pick up four of them with the tractor and loader. Two at a time, no problem. Fire lifter is awkward, shall we say. Time I messed about the bale lifter, just quicker doing it this way. I'd say the price might be going up slightly. Don't get too carried away, Nathan, because the price is still going up. Get rid of a few, then we'll stop. Yeah, I guess that's an option. Means you're moving a few more gates and things about for us, though. That'd work, wouldn't it, Milton? Don't do too many more now. Little field down there to do as well as grass. I am thinking we might do all pit silage this time now, rather than putting more bales on here. Don't know how much that pit holds between the two barns. Thank you. Just get these ones cleared up, you put overhead knife, and then that'll do it for Bile Selma for now. Thinned a good few of them out. Sell the rest of them off stream. Hasn't hit us in the yard here at the moment. How many swaths you pair got lying about at the moment? Because that causes lag as well. For some reason.
It's just near the yard that we have lag.
Right. Bales then. And a lot of machinery. Could be the little squares, I suppose. There's a lot of them there. Thanks, Peter. We've tried to do something different with them. Welcome along. Tried to do something what I hadn't seen anyone else doing. Headlands done that field now.
Yep.
Just thinking getting them swathed cleared before we do the middle too much. Nathan's now on his way down to here with the rake. Just try to think of how we can minimise the amount of lag we're getting. It's not always easy to do realism, and we have a few issues with that one on there. Best, but we occasionally have an issue. I've been hearing about it in here.
has been mentioned, Steve, and I haven't seen it myself yet.
Remember, if you're enjoying the stream, hit that like button. It'd be much appreciated, please. If you look at mods, Stephen, a lot of them have files for other tractors and other bits and pieces. It is. That's the one I think it was. It certainly was not a good one. Not in my own opinion. Before anyone jumps on me. This grass does look so much better on here. I think we're going to get a few trailerfuls off here so far. No, that's the one we were using on here. It does have a few issues with it. Thank you. Here we go again. Don't think we could get very far somehow. It's a lot quicker on the flat. It's better. How quick were we expecting the trailers to be full? I think you boys could be busy on here. Evening, Dan. How are you doing? I get the feeling that clamp is going to get full rather quickly. We're going to need a third trailer. I think you deserve a medal for this one, Nathan. Get this forager done in 24 hours. It is Seamus. Welcome along. Yeah, you've done really well to get this converted over since last night. Once you guys get going with the trials, that might pay to go around in a circle.
I'll go down the sawmill track. And out onto the other road to avoid a collision somewhere.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Don't think there's going to be much difference in length, is there? For time to get back. Oh, 900 is a nice forager. How'd you find the wagon after being on a trail chopper? That's always a big debate there. Yes, better suggestion too, Nathan. Go up the sawmill track off the field, it'll be quicker, loaded. It's not so steep. Yeah, swings and roundabouts, I guess. You're getting as good a quality silage from it, though. That's the main thing. And this is coming from someone who's an arable person and knows a little bit about them. I don't think Formal's gone crying into his Pepsi, do you? He's missing silage. I think it's to the point because he had a fourth trailer at the moment. Every time I go get a screenshot, things go wrong up here. That's a big yield of grass on here. Okay, 1134. That's three trailerfuls off the first headland round
so far.
Yes, there is a third one up the yard, 1174. Where are they all at the moment, the Westerns? You've got two of them. Where's the third one, Milton?
It's at the combine shed. Outside the combine shed.
Outside the combine shed, 1174. So there should be three up there. Yeah, we've got someone locally here, Seamus, who's got an indoor Holstein herd who does that. I think I've got a big crone wagon, the front mower. Do zero grazing with that. Shop I got the motherboard off first tomorrow rather than the computer shop. Just mentioned to them about the RAM problem.
because they're more likely to refund me or replace it than what the computer shop is, I'd have thought. Still just as handy, isn't it? His aren't indoor all the time, I don't think. Not all of them, anyway. They did invest a lot of money into them the other year. To go with the other part of the business. Panic, Thomas, I think, is the answer. If this lot turned to hay. Don't think there's any danger of that. It's also kind of what I want to get done quick. Took about 5 hours last time, didn't have to go to hay on here. Have you got the horn with me? I don't think we'd be doing 14k in these swaths in real life, the size they are. Somehow. Speed bump. Did you guys remember to put the L plates on this third trailer? Good point, Jeremy. Get you on the other side of me now, if you like. Need more space if you guys are on the right, I think. Won't be so close to the tractor then. This is the updated version of Oakfield, Seamus. It's a sheep by point, because this field and the one to my left are now sheep fields as well. Gives us a bit more space for you on that side. Do class actually make a trail forager anymore? Class may want one in the future though, because they do like their heritage stuff. You've got to look at what scale models are out there from class in that respect. I didn't think they still made the trailed one. Because the numbers would be so low, it would be awkward, I'd have thought. Yeah, exactly. I'll dominate at 105 and Trail Forager. I used to, Seamus. Used to be a main tractor driver on a farm. Combine driver, potato harvester. Have driven the Jaguar 900 for a couple of days in the past on maize as well. Never surprised me if we didn't actually see a lot more John Deere stuff, to be honest. Okay, so honest answers for you guys then. Which grass do you prefer, this one or the one which was on here in the update? Oh, that's a nice fleet, Seamus. As you can tell by what I'm running on here, I'm a bit of a Ford fan. I had a feeling you might like this one better, Jeremy. I prefer this one.
This one?
Yeah. And that's not any criticism of Roxy's work. His new grass is good. Just takes some getting used to. It just floats a little bit more than I'd like. Manual attach. We've had a few issues with it on multiplayer before, haven't we, Milton?
Yeah, we have.
We're a little bit nervous about using manual attach on the multiplayer server. It caused us a few issues on another server, so we removed it. I haven't tried the updated version. Ooh, you got some nice ones there. 7840 stock, or have they had a tweak to them? Oh, dynamic hoses, yeah, they're... These ones wouldn't have dynamic hoses on. Okay, Thomas. Trailers haven't, this hasn't, but a lot of stuff has, we're using. Two 7840s where I've helped out before had turbos put on them, Seamus. One was 150 and one was 160 horsepower. One used to use a 6-row sugar beet harvester on it. Trailed one. Always get one who goes on the other side of you, don't you?
Oh, there's a lot of stuff that ain't out there from JD yet. But John Deere are very, very protective of what they have in the game. I'm happier just having a class one than a John Deere one myself. Lost count of how many trailers we had now. Oh, they can make a classic DLC. If they want to. There's mods out there, but they're not made by Giants. Just because there's mods don't mean they can't come from Giants as a DLC as well. Just don't forget the console guys haven't got them. I don't know where you get that idea from, Sam. Class is a lot better than Kubota coming into the game. They've got a wider range to offer. No, they're not Barn Lodge, not these ones. The Trailed Harvester is definitely private. It's not even finished yet. It's almost finished. The Trailed Harvester was put on the server at 10 to 7 tonight. Gives you an idea how late we got it. Nathan has been working his socks off trying to get this done for us. Yeah, I know there's a Torian mod out there. I know he's working on a built from the ground up one as well. There are some Richard Westerns out there that are public. It's not just not these ones. Yeah, whatever, Sam. Know what I'd rather drive than John Deere, especially combine wise. That comes after driving the kit since 1997. Does that say John Deere are good looking tractors?
Yeah, we had a John Deere 2058. If the straw got so much, a little bit damp, it'd stop feeding stuff in, you'd have to stop. And the W540 to feed it in no matter what it was like, but you couldn't get grass seed out of the grain tank. Considering we grew grass seed, it's a bit of a problem to us. And that's a brand new combine. Oh, not that old chestnut, Sam. You see more class combines that had fires, there's more of them about than any other brand, but I can show you pictures of New Hollands that have burnt, Case that have burnt, Massey's that have burnt. They all do it, especially if... Sorry?
John Deere's.
John Deere's, yep. If you go to America, you'll see more burnt out John Deere's. Go to Australia, you'll probably see more burnt out John Deere's as well, because there's more of them. The class seem to have got that one sorted with the new ones. And half the reason they fly a fire is all the emission stuff they have to have on them now. That's whatever brand it is. You start putting catalytic converters and DPF kits on a machine that works in straw and dust, you're going to get a fire sooner or later. Ask anyone who's worked with them how hot those kits get. Favourite brand, Chris, would be what you're looking at on here. That'd be New Holland or Case. Ford New Holland Case. As Farmer Dan knows, my last new tractor was a Case, what I had on the farm. Puma. Hey Austin, how are we doing? Good, thanks. You think our rake man's on the coffee break again? Why's what, Austin? Very true, Dan. Coming from a man who's about to be driving a Fendt or a John Deere, that's interesting. I do think your would-be employer will like that one very much. Good question, Austin. Could be 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, who knows. Okay, Jeremy. I thought you might have disappeared soon. Fendt have lost their way as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, I do like Fords. Comes from my upbringing. Trying to read chat whilst doing that.
these Fords are one of them, Austin. The 7700 ain't bad tractor, neither's 3070 if the gearbox is staying one piece. What's that, Austin? You enjoying Barn Lodge, agri-technician, etc.? Our 454s just keep going, those things. A few people are running them still. Okay, catch you later, Jeremy. Not off the top of my head, I don't, but you can fill me in. I shall be back in 2 moments. That's the one, Jeremy.
That's alright then, Austin. That can be both a blessing and a curse, that one, Barn Lodge. I have. Last fin I drove was a 718 old style. Not as new as your man's. No, they're not. How often do I stream? Usually every night at 7. May do extra on a Saturday and Sunday. Can we get to 20 likes tonight? What do you reckon? It's usually a goal now. The long stream. That's alright then. So good. I think this forage has done us well tonight. We might be working Nathan rather hard on the pit at the moment. I don't know, Jeremy. Could be worth a look. Imagine if the bales are held in suspended animation, they're not going to take up space. October at the earliest, I would think, Dan. I haven't seen the new schedules yet. Oh yeah, definitely laggy up the yard end. Multitasking now. Okay, Sam. We'll take a look in a bit.
I'll get these headlands cleared tonight on here, then that'll do us, I think. Dread to think what's in the pit. I'll be with you in a moment, Milton. Just had to rake a bit so we can get going again. Oh, it does sometimes, Jeremy. Trust me. I've hit more than one swath of that thing. No way the 6810 would manage this trailer. No, that's why I was just wanting to do this, the headlands to start with, Nathan, just see how we got on more than anything. I'll have to just slow down a bit, Milton. Hit the limit, height wise. Ah, now we've got another three or four trailers now, have we? Maybe. Okay, five or six trailers. Yeah. 615,238 litres. Yeah, I think we're going to have to install another pit somewhere. Don't you? How about that small grass field beside the where the lime spreader's kept?
Yeah, that's a nice place.
If we cut it first and just cleared it?
Yeah.
That's the one, Jeremy. This thing will put a fairly big clamp on there. That's already got a load in it, Thomas. From first cut, although it's nowhere near as full as what this one is. I mean, I suppose that's the only other option, is empty that clamp out into a silo if we can find one. Works for seasons. I don't know, Nathan. Yeah, we'll have a think about it, Thomas. We'll have a discussion in our little hoity hole in Discord about that one. See what we're going to do. We're getting far more silage than I thought we were going to get. I don't think any of us thought we could get this much, did we?
No, I think I was thinking a low amount, like
yeah.
The first cut.
This time that's fully fertilised, isn't it?
And lime.
Yeah, it's a damn good job we didn't do bales this time. Every trial you're taking is the equivalent to 5 bales, roughly, isn't it?
Yeah, probably.
I don't know how many you've done, but let's do some quick maths here. We'd already had 169 bales, roughly. We wouldn't want them to be doing them, would we?
Your months off there.
Yeah. So there's 675,000 litres in the clamp. Probably by now, 4,000 in that is near 169 times. So. Straw to do yet. Yep, no update for Greenwich yet. It's not broken for season, it's just not converted to seasons. It's the trees what need doing and the snow mask. There's no idea. Which one would you try, Nathan?
this forge is working really well. Yeah, Greenwich is a good map. That's the best British one though. Good map, but everyone will have a different idea what they think the best one is. Hey Brendan, how are we doing? You wait till you see the update in Meadowgrove. The one problem with this server is steering lag. I'm good, thanks. Meadowgrove is obviously going to be one of my favourites, regardless of me saying that if Nathan weren't listening. Oakfield is a good one for MP, no two ways about that. But Culbra Park Farm has to be up there. It's too many really to say what's the best one. Culbra, West Coast, both very, very good maps. I find it very hard to pick a best one out of all of them. As I say, they all got to stop at some point, Sam. And BB doesn't like 19. You don't like something, you can't do anything for it. Exactly, Nathan. Well, we certainly made a clearance on here. Yeah, there's some fields around my part of the world you can do similar with. Oh, Pitman's on the trailer. Best behaviour.
Okay, catch hello 1174.
It's the thing with MP, you just get too involved in it and lose track of time. I think we'd have filled this clamp with this whole field without any of the other one in it. At least the volume in the swath sort of matches the height of the grass now. You PS4 controller, aren't you, Milton?
Yeah,
PS4 controller. Sam. Catch it, Lilo 1174. Okay, catch later, tried to go. We won't go much longer anyway. Let's get this headland finished. Glad you enjoyed it. We thought you'd enjoy it once you got on here with us.
Good luck with that one. You try sending her out for night, she'll know something's up. That was interesting. Never seen it go forwards out of the thing before. You're confusing the spout, Nathan. That was an interesting little glitch. Let's get a couple of misbits there. Back up the yard now. Yeah, it's the server lag with steering is causing problems, 1174. Yeah, Nathan done a nice job with this harvester. Don't think we'll be swapping harvesters for a little horn here, put it that way. Clear all those misbits up the bale and dump the grass straight in one of the cattle troughs. It is SG, 100% private. And the lag is back. Okay, that just looks wrong. That really looks wrong, how that pressure washer's been held there. Interesting idea, Thomas. Giants didn't think about that when they worked out how the pressure washer should be held, did they? You can now see, can you?
Yeah, thanks.
Impressive if you could do it. You're a heck of a set of point work you got there. You think so, Chris? Got a pretty strong toilet bowl. Splash back if you get some plumbing like that. I'll find the magic spot on the front whites again. Just seems to be one spot if you get this that'll wash them. Welcome back, Stephen. Is that tractor just had a respray?
Yeah, it was becoming awful.
Yeah. It's not all in yet, Stephen. I think our pit is just about full. As you can see, yeah, we try to work out what we're going to do next. It's all got to go in a pit because we can't have this many bales about here. We've only done the headlands on the other field. Yeah, that's one option. As you can see, we're not going to get too much more on this one. $744,301. These hold about a million normally, do they? Too much more in there. Well, this one's a smaller one than usual. I was wondering about placeable clamp on air. It's flat enough. About the only place we could put one, I think, on that down there. We may get a buck rake eventually. This one here, we have a buck rake, but as Nathan will tell you himself, he's not finished it yet. It's workable, but it's not finished. Works perfectly. Yep, done by Nathan for the server. Pray for Cap. We knew we had a lot of silage to do and he wanted the buck rake to do it with. To fit in with the age machinery we're using. There's no old loading shovels knocking about at the minute, unfortunately, to suit. Gives you something to do until 4 o'clock in the morning, pray for Cap. trouble is that whilst he's doing that, he's not working on the Metagrove update. It gives him time to get inspiration for doing that. I've started to learn how to convert things. Oh, you're back on Metagrove tonight, are you? Yeah. Have you seen how much land we've actually done, Formal? As to where that silage actually comes from. It will be, Sam, a lot bigger. 200 plus fields, I think they're talking about the last estimate, wasn't it, Nathan? So all we've done, Formal, is this chunk of headland on this field. Plus... this field. That's it. That's all what's in that clamp. No, the new Metagrove is massive. $200 altogether. Don't think you'd be able to get 200 new fields on there of a decent size. Yeah, but this time it's fully fertilised and limed, isn't it, Formal? Last time it wasn't. I think I could pretty much fill the map area now. Two and three at times, Formal. Three when we could manage it. We could have done with four trailers at times tonight. How quick I was filling them up. The new harvester is a big improvement over the old one. Be a few weeks yet, Sam. Especially by the time it actually gets out. It's got to go through his testers and then Giant's testing before you get a chance to see it. Oh, someone's playing with the John Deere's. Just think how many trailers we need if we were doing field 35 with grass silage. If three of you struggled to keep me going this close to the yard. They're not 7, 8, 10, Sam. Those 7-800s we got on here, the 10s are too new. How haven't got a maze head of this harvester formal. So unless we get an old Jag mod or something like that, other than that Dawn thing which is out there, it sort of rules it out. I presume you're still in here when we have seen the new harvester. Have you not seen the new harvester formal? We've not been using the New Holland tonight. We have a Mengele now. Breaking things mostly, Sam. Who have we got on the server with us, formal? He's very good at anything to do with mods. Yes, formal. You got her. I think our mission on here, between this stream and one of the next ones, is get rid of loads of biles somehow. Try and free this lag up. Oh, I know several farmers who won't do that over here. One or two do, but not many. Don't get that one stuck on that clamp, Nathan, that's bad enough when we've done it on the other one. How far out is that sheet going to come when that's covered, do you think? Right, thought you might. No one that's not a big enough clamp to have two on, really. Hey Hamish, how are we doing?
Yeah, I think that could have been kept going for a little bit longer as well, to be honest. I think that's still got the views because it was extremely popular. Hey Carrasco, how we doing? Well, apparently I can't tip that anymore. Save yourself, clamp. Can't be that bad because he's getting monster views on it, Sam. People are enjoying it, so it's obviously working. Yep, England. Well, most of us, some of us on here, not all of us on the server are England. I think the problem with doing that, Thomas, is the complicated scripts that we need. We've got it on cattle and crops, but there's some complex scripts behind it. Yeah, this loader has been a little bit sensitive on the pit about emptying. To be honest, I don't think anything would have the same feel as it did in 17. Okay, catch you later, Sam. Hey Dakota, how are you doing? Doing that too much. Pain when that refill itself coming off the clamp. Yeah, I don't like rolling clamps either, Hamish. I have done it. Especially some of the ones we used to do when I worked for a little while. You're not stuck, are you, Nathan? No, I don't. Okay, catch you later, Milton. All right. Not bad, thanks, Hamish. A bit of paperwork, which is my favourite job. He even turned some work down today for a few weeks' time, which is unlike me. Okay, Nathan. More and go be able to pile up there with the tractor and loader. Run out of reach. As Nathan's gone for a quick break, I think that's where we'll finish for tonight. It's getting on 10:30 now anyway, so I am going to say for now, pop a link to one of today's videos in chat. Obviously there's been two today, there'll be one tomorrow. Don't know if we'll stream yet tomorrow night. I'll see what happens to my PC during the day tomorrow after speaking to a couple of people. But for now, I'm going to say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this stream, and I'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.